Good evening to everybody who is present here on my YouTube channel, that is Mod. For all those of math background or maybe somebody who knows the meaning of mod, that means everything within the mod gets positive. That is what my channel is. Everybody who is present here will grow, whether they are masters in biology or they are not, but they will grow in their own aspects. Today we are locked in our houses, not at all wanting to study because we don't have books, we don't have those classrooms, we don't have those teachers, those tuition centers, those points, those musties and everything. But today I am here for those who don't have their books, who are very keen to read word by word, but that is a good thing because in the NCRTs and wherever you have been there, the board people, they can ask you any word from especially the biology NCRT because they say that this is your sacred book from now. You need to know each and every word that is there, and plus those who don't have their books can, you know, go along with me as I will read word to word. That is the newest form or the idea that I have invented for teaching you all, because some videos are there which give you a broad outline, but when it comes to answering questions and going word to word, because sometimes we have small tests which cannot be prepared with such small you know slides or maybe certain YouTube videos. I'm not saying they're not good, but for children or you know people who need to study word by word in detail, you can do that. And those who don't like reading, they just need to, you know, listen to my videos so that they can complete the chapter by just listening to them. Okay, so let's start. The first chapter is reproduction of organisms. So each and every organism can live only for a certain period of time. The period from birth to the natural death of an organism represents its lifespan. So they are saying that every organism, her ek organism, lives for a certain period of time, and that is called as the lifespan. Jab se wo paida hui hain, towards their natural death is known as the lifespan. Lifespan of a few organisms have been given on the next page, and some needs to be found out. Isn't it both interesting and intriguing to know that some are only a few days and some are for so many years and still growing? Between them are the true extremes of the lifespans of most of the organisms. Like, there are certain extremes, that is a few seconds or maybe a few hours to, you know, millions of years that have been there. So the sizes don't matter. Here it is written that you may note that the lifespan of organisms are not necessarily correlated with their sizes. That is the size of the crow and that of the parrot, it is almost same. But their lifespans are entirely different. Now coming to the plant kingdom, that is the mango tree and the peepal tree. They both have the same sizes. But, you know, the peepal tree grows anywhere, and it has a longer lifespan as compared to the mango tree. Whatever be the lifespan, death of all organisms is, you know, given. There, nothing is immortal, but there are certain single-celled organisms that are immortal. And there are thousands of plant species that are, you know, growing around us. The animals are growing around us. There must be some process with the help of which they give rise to new entities, to their own generations, to their own morphs, or, you know, their new organisms. And this is called as the reproduction. So going on, here has been given, you have to find out the lifespan. Here it is like butterfly, 1 to 2 weeks. Crow, 15 years, and here parrot is 140 years. I told you their sizes are same, but there is a major difference, so much difference, like 120 years, only 10th of this. So moving on, here tortoise is 100 to 150 years long living, and that's why it is very sacred and found to be nice. So now the theory. Reproduction is defined as a biological process in which an organism gives rise to young ones, offsprings similar to itself. The offsprings grow, mature, and in turn reproduce new offsprings. Thus, there is a cycle of birth, growth, and death. Reproduction enables the continuity of the species generation after generation. You will study later in chapter 5. See, here, what is reproduction now? Reproduction is the process. It is the biological process. Here biological process means something that is related to bio. Bio means life, and logical means something that has been derived from the living things. And जो हमारे living organisms होते हैं वो अपने जैसे अपने organisms को birth देते हैं, उसके बाद वो organisms mature करते हैं, grow करते हैं, and they another offspring is being developed. So there is a cycle going on. पेरेंट डैम ने बच्चे को बर्थ दिया, बच्चा बड़ा हुआ, उसने अपने बच्चों को बर्थ दिया, अगेन डेथ, एंड देन अगेन द लाइफ साइकिल गोज ऑन. सो रिप्रोडक्शन इज नेसेसरी फॉर द कंटिन्यूटी, एंड इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन दैट देर इज कंटिन्यूटी. देर इज अ लार्ज डाइवर्सिटी इन द बायोलॉजिकल वर्ल्ड, एंड ईच ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैज इवॉल्व देयर ओन मैकेनिजम्स टू मल्टीप्लाई एंड प्रोड्यूस ऑफ स्प्रिंग्स. यहाँ पे अराउंड अस देर इज अ लार्ज बायोडाइवर्सिटी मीन्स देर इज डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ एनिमल्स, plants that are present here, and they have evolved their own mechanism like sexual, asexual, vegetative propagation and many other a spores, or you know, plants have evolved their own methods of reproduction. So according to their needs, according to the environment they are growing in, and sometimes they reproduce within months, some in weeks, some in years. Like human beings, they take 9 months. So there are different time spans, time periods and methods that have been evolved. The organism's habitat, its internal physiology and several other factors are collectively responsible for how it reproduces. See, the habitat I told, the environment that it is living in, maybe it is hot, it is humid, it is sometimes rainy, sometimes it is, you know, full of mud, sometimes it is very dry, arid conditions, you never know where the organism is living. Internal physiology means whether there is a developed system in that organism or not, whether it would be capable of going on into the sexual reproduction or the asexual reproduction, whether it has the capability of giving rise to new organisms by itself, or whether it will divide upon itself. See, based on whether there is participation of one organism or the two in the process of reproduction, it is of two types. When offspring is produced by a single parent with or without the involvement of a gamete formation, it is called as asexual reproduction. When two parents opposite sex participate in the reproductive process and also involve fusion of male and female gametes, it is called as the sexual reproduction. Here they have been given that there are mainly two kinds of reproduction depending upon the involvement of the number of organisms that are present. First, the ones there is only one parent, whether there is or not the gamete being involved in it or not, it is called as asexual reproduction. And the sexual reproduction is when two organisms are involved, where the gametes fused, two kinds of gamete fused together to give rise to a new gamete, a new fusion, it is called as the sexual reproduction. Moving on to the asexual reproduction. Here, in this method, a single individual parent is capable of producing offsprings. As a result, the offsprings that are produced are not only identical to one another, but are also exact copies of their parents. Are these offsprings likely to be genetically identical or not? The term clone is used to refer such morphologically and genetically similar individuals. So here they are saying asexual reproduction is the reproduction of the offsprings, which is done only by a single parent. And the offsprings, they are produced not only morphologically. Here morphologically means the external appearance, shape, size, color, or maybe there are spikes or some rough structures on the surface or not, but genetically. Genetical makeup here means the DNA, chromosomes, genes. See, here I would be like you to show you. Here is the entire one cell that is there. It is growing, it is making replicating things, making more material. Then there is division, there is spindle formation here, and then it divides up into two daughter cells. Only one parent is involved, giving rise to two new cells that are exactly morphologically and genetically copies of each other. And here also there is bud formation. It is the nucleus. The nucleus, the spindle formation is taking place. The two nucleuses have been, this is the vacuole and this is the nucleus. This is starting to divide, and so that it can be a cell that is independent of the parent, bud formation, and then the bud will detach off. So these are the types of asexual reproduction. Let us see how widespread the asexual reproduction is among different groups of organisms. Asexual reproduction is common among single-celled organisms and in plants and animals with relatively simple organism. In protists and monerans, the organism of the parent cell divides into two to give rise to new individuals. So, like I told you that depending upon whether it has the intact or the internal physiology capable enough of going through the sexual reproduction, the plant would undergo or the animal would undergo reproduction. Here, the asexual reproduction, we need to know that whether it is among the common or the uncommon process. Most of the single-celled organism, because they don't have such a machinery or a very developed system inside them, so the protists and the monera, if you know the animal kingdom, they are the most, you know, earliest organisms evolved and single-celled in nature. So the one I showed you here, that is this one here, the organism is growing and dividing. This belongs to protists and monera, okay? And here, thus these are also, you know, pictures. Thus, in these organisms, cell division itself is a mode of transportation. So, here the cell division, just the division of the cell, that is making of new cell, is a mode of reproduction because they are the primitive ones. They are not grown enough. Many single cell organisms produced by binary fission. Binary means two, where a cell divides into two halves and each rapidly grows into an adult. An example here is amoeba and paramecium. So there comes two definitions. One is cell division. Cell division is the division of cell, and in the primitive organisms it is the mode of reproduction. And binary division is when a single cell organism, or maybe a single organism, gets divided into two halves and goes rapidly into individuals or adults. It is called as binary fission. And here it is, amoeba and paramecium are the examples of such. In yeast, the division is unequal and small buds, the one I showed you, where the nucleus divided, then the bud formed, and then afterwards there is detachment of the bud that remains attached to the initially to the parent cells, and eventually it gets separated. Members of the kingdom fungi and simple plants such as algae produce through special asexual reproductive structures. The most common of these structures are known as the zoospores, that usually are microscopic structures. So here there are asexual means of reproduction where there are certain organisms, like in the kingdom fungi and algae, they have been started producing through these special kind of structures which are called as the zoospores. Here I am going to show you zoospores. See, these are the zoospores that you are seeing. The kingdom fungi, algae, they grow in such a special structure like thing. Moving on. Here, next is other common asexual means are conidia, seen in penicillium, and bulbs, seen in hydra, and gemmules, that are seen in sponges. See, conidia, seen in penicillium. You need to know all these because your teachers can ask you, or maybe in the board, you may be asked what is the kind of reproduction going on and what organisms are involved in such a reproduction. Correct? And here the buds are seen in, I showed you, in hydra, and the gemmules in sponges. Here the entire figure, these are the gemmules in the sponges, and this is an important figure. This has come in sometimes exams, so you need to know it. Here are also some asexual modes of reproduction, but in plants, that were in the animals. Here we are talking about, but the algae one was there, but here we are, you know, concentrating more on the animal plant kingdom rather on the animal kingdom. So you have learned about the vegetative reproduction in plants in class 11. What do you think, is vegetative reproduction also a type of asexual reproduction? Why do you say so in the term clone applicable to the offsprings formed by vegetative reproduction? Here we are talking about vegetative reproduction. Vegetative reproduction is the mode I told you where a plant from its entirely single thing grows into something that gets detached. Firstly, it is attached to the parent body, and then it gets attached to the itself entire environment that is present. Yes, it is a mode of asexual reproduction. Why? Because only a single parent is involved, there is no gamete formation, and then it gets detached from the parent body. It is a primitive system, there is no fusion of gametes. So here are the examples where I showed you like the buds. While animals and other simple organisms, the term asexual is used unambiguously. Unambiguously matlab kahin pe bhi hum use kar sakte hain jab hum simple organisms ki baat karte hain. In plants, the term vegetative reproduction is frequently used. In plants, we use vegetative reproduction in place of the asexual reproduction because there is a better way of saying it. And in plants, the units of vegetative production are such as runners, rhizome, sucker, tuber, ovipositor, bulb are all capable of giving rise to new offsprings. The structures are called as the vegetative propagules. Propagules ka matlab hota hai jiski wajah se uski generation aage badh rahi hai, the mode through which they are growing. Obviously, since the formation of these structures does not involve two parents and hence they are asexual. Here, the eyes of the germinating potatoes, these are very, you know, common in our houses. Here is the ginger, there is the bulb, and there is bryophyllum. This is very common, and a question can come, how does bryophyllum reproduce? And these are offsprings of hyacinth that is found in water. You must have heard about the scourge of water bodies or about the terror of Bengal. This is nothing but the aquatic plant water hyacinth, which is one of the most invasive weeds found growing wherever there is standing water. It drains oxygen from the water, which leads to the death of fishes. You will read about more in the following chapters. You may find it interesting to know that this plant was introduced in India because of its beautiful flowers and shape of flowers. Since it can propagate vegetatively at a phenomenal rate and spread all over the water body in a short period of time, it is very difficult to get rid of them. So here they were saying that I showed you the water hyacinth, and there was the terror of Bengal because it was brought in India because of its beautiful flowers. Now, as it is asexually reproducing, it does not require two plant bodies or two gametes to get fused and then produce a new body. It only requires one thing, that is the own parent. It gives rise to new, and here it propagates at a very large speed. You may have seen them in jodas or standing water that drain of the water. They take a lot of water and oxygen and deprive the other organisms that are growing there. Another example is the Indian Congress grass, which is seen somewhere in the, you know, regions that are open and not kept care of. So these are the methods by which they can reproduce. Are you aware of how the plants like potato, sugarcane, banana, ginger, dahlia are cultivated? Potato through the eyes, I have showed you. Sugarcane through the roots. Banana also grown and on the trees. And ginger and dahlia, they are through the rhizomes. Have you seen small plants emerging from the buds called as the eyes of the potato tuber from the rhizomes of banana and ginger? You have seen them. Where you carefully try to determine the site of origin of the new plantlet in the plants listed above, you will notice that there are invariably arise from the nodes present in the modified stem of these plants. Modified stem here means that part where the vegetative propagules or vegetative reproduction is taking place, and that plant part is known as nodes. When the nodes come in contact with the damp soil or water, they produce roots and new plants because they require water, certain nutrients and the soil to grow in. So here the nodes, when they come in contact with the damp soil that contains nutrients, water, soil, everything that the plant needs, they start to grow. Similarly, adventitious buds rise from the notches present at the margins of the leaf of bryophyllum. I showed you there, they don't require any soil, they just need the leaf itself, that is the parent leaf. This ability is fully exploited by gardeners and farmers for commercial propagation of such plants. Here the commercial propagation means that they are exploited, means like the collection of roses you may have seen in Chandigarh. There is only one thing coming in, that is the plant, which is, you know, certain part of the plant is required and the entire new plant part can be grown. It is interesting to note that the asexual reproduction is the common method of reproduction in organisms that have a relatively simple organization. As I told you, that when the internal organization is well developed, only then they can have sexual reproduction. But where there is simple, not so developed, the asexual reproduction takes place, like algae and fungi, and they shift to sexual mode of reproduction just under the onset of adverse conditions or the conditions, like I told you, the environment changes, the mode of reproduction changes, they evolve, they make new family members, and like that. Find out how sexual reproduction enables these organisms to survive during unfavorable conditions. Why is sexual reproduction favored under such conditions? Asexual, vegetative, asexual in animals, vegetative in plants, as well as sexual modes of reproduction are exhibited by higher plants. There I had showed you that smaller organisms or the primitive ones, they follow asexual reproduction, whereas the more advanced ones, those have the ability, the capability, the machinery, the modes, the sources through which they can grow sexually, they only reproduce through sexual mode of reproduction. On the other hand, sexual mode of reproduction is represented by almost all the animals, whether they are small, whether they are big, or whether the kind of organisms they are going through. So thank you so much for your attention. I know you are very patient throughout my video. Thank you for being so. And I was also a student, so I know that there cannot be a concentration more than this. So we would be back again with a new video. For any doubts and queries, you may come to me, and I would kindly request you to revise just a small portion of this so that we can revise it, and it would help you in further in the chapter. Thank you.